Hello everyone. So today in this video, I'm going to discuss about is this the right time for you to buy a house? Let me start by saying that I'm going to be very honest, and this is my opinion and what I see coming. Well, my name is Luciana Rivera with Dalton Reid Real Estate Group, a local realtor here in the Tampa Bay area. Lately, I have been getting a lot of questions about how is the market now? It's crazy time now, isn't it? And I know that no one expected this pandemic to happen. And when it did happen, some thought it would be here and then be gone. But I must say that once it kept on, I was a little worried, not only because of business in general, but also for the housing market. But what do you know? The market stayed strong. And I remember that in April, we would only see people that still had their job in the market buying, putting offers. Now you see more buyers in the market due to the interest rate being so low. But then again, I get these other questions. Isn't houses high right now? Shouldn't we wait until the houses go down? And there's still a lot of people thinking that the houses are going to drop like it did in 2008. Let's clarify a little bit here before I really get started on this buying. First, in 2008, what happened is that the market were qualifying people that really had no business qualifying. As long as they breathed and had, even if they were just one day at a job, they would qualify them. That's not the case now. They have learned from those mistakes and they're being very careful. They're not doing the same mistake. And now due to the loss of jobs, because of the pandemic, some people are not being able to pay their mortgage. This could cause to have more houses in the market down the line. Now, of course, sellers could possibly put their house for sale if they can't pay for it. But some would just leave it to where it could fall to foreclosure. And that's when there are more houses in the market, the prices might drop slowly due to less demand. But I think houses will drop between 5 to 12% in prices, nothing like before. Either way, real estate is up and down. It has shown that it's normally every 10 years, but again, that is never certain. And the reason for that, because of the economy, but most important, the inventory demand. Not enough houses in the market makes the prices go up, which becomes the seller's market. That's what we're on now, and we have been the past few years. Too many houses in the market makes the prices go down, which makes it a buyer's market. Here's what I have to say about all of this. Buying a house, it's not like buying a car. It's a lot more money involved. You need to be financially ready to buy a house. So if you're thinking about buying a house, make sure that you have at least 5 to 7% of the price of the house to be safe. Make sure that you live in that house a minimum of 5 to 10 years. If you just got married, try to buy something that is 3-bedroom if you plan on having kids. Think long term. Don't buy a house right now thinking of making a profit in 3 to 4 years, or if you know that you're going to be moving somewhere else around that time. This is not the time for that. I remember I just talked to a couple last month in June, in July, or in August, yeah, in July, about the time you're buying. They told me that they wanted to sell their house and go to something smaller, but they also told me that in 3 years that they were gonna be moving. So I told them, wait, don't do that yet. Check your interest rate. Does it make sense for you to refinance so you can drop your mortgage right now? But talk to your lender and see if that's what you need to do. And for those of you that are looking to buy right now, take advantage of the low interest because you never know what the interest rate will be later on. Also remember that you have a fixed rate and your mortgage payment will be the same for 30 years or as long as you own the house. We all know that rent right now is very high and it only keeps getting higher. Not to mention that for you to even rent a house nowadays, you have to come up with at minimum of 3 times the rent just to sign that lease paper. And I will say this, when buying a house, we all love that perfect house. We all want to make sure that when we move into the house, it's all ready, you don't have to do anything. But sometimes it make more sense for you to put an offer on that kitchen that doesn't have a granite on it due to multiple offers. You don't want to be in that bidding war. So looking to something like that, that might save you a little bit more money, because maybe just putting that granite or just fixing up that whole kitchen, it might be cheaper than finding a home that has all of that all at once. Just something to think about. You know your finances. The thing that I have to say is we all have to live somewhere. If you have the means to buy the house and you're going to be living there for at least 5 to 10 years, do it, because 5 to 10 years go by very fast, and so does that money. If you're renting, and I'm going to give you this example right now, if you're renting a house that is $1,500 a month, 5 years from now, it's $90,000 that you've pretty much paid somebody else's mortgage. 10 years from now is $180,000, and you will never see that money again. At least if you want to sell or have to sell for whatever reason, you'll get most of that money back. Now, as far as buying a house to rent it out or flip it, I don't think it's a good idea. I would wait. Unless you have a lot of money and you just have to invest on something anyways, because there is a demand in rental, right? We all know that. And as far as flip, it's very hard to find flips right now. I mean, unless if you find something that you can get a really good deal on it. So what do you think? Are you ready to buy, or do you have to save a little bit more money to get your home? Let me know if there's any other questions you might have. Hey, and for those of you that have more experience in financing or housing market, let me know, where do you see all of this heading to? And please subscribe, hit the notification bell to get more videos about real estate topics, and don't forget to like this video. Also, you can reach all of my social media information at RiveraFloridaHomes.com. Till my next video. Bye-bye.